The following is an overview of the MotionLab3 software, its main features, and how the whole graphical user interface is structured and built. This tutorial is based on MotionLab3 1.3.5 version and 1.5.2 firmware version. And if you are not using these specific versions, you might find slight changes in some steps or in some features along the whole interface. First of all, this tutorial also assumes that you have already installed MotionLab3 in your computer and that you are connected to your drive. If you haven't, please go through the video tutorial how to connect to your servo drive through Ethernet or whatever communication interface you're using, and then continue. Once installed, if you open MotionLab3, you will get the following welcome window. In it, we can distinguish different regions with different tools used for different purposes. First of all, under the new project, you will find different project options with Start Now buttons that will bring you to the configuration wizard, a guided step-by-step process that will allow you to configure the different parts of your system. For example, the parameters of your motor, feedback sensors, motor temperature sensor, electromagnetic brake, and so on, so that once you finish it, you have a system that is already operational. Then, under the Get Started title, you will find tutorial suggestions that will appear as tabs in the middle of your screen so that you can learn more about the software and maybe troubleshoot some of the issues that you might find along the way. On the top right corner of your screen, you can find a set of buttons that relate to the main features that the MotionLab3 has. These are, starting from left to right, the Drive Explorer, which is a widget that allows you to see all the drives being interfaced through MotionLab3 as well as a full list of the parameters in the dictionary of the firmware of such a drive. Then we have the display. This is a widget that allows you to see how any parameter of the drive changes over time. These changes are shown in a numerical manner, as you can see. Then we can find the control. This is a widget that allows you to write and modify any parameter that is available in the dictionary of the drive. After this, we can find the scope. This is a widget with the same purpose as the display, but in this case, the changes are shown in a graphical representation. Then we find the signal generator. This is a widget used for tuning purposes. It allows you basically to configure a demand command signal that you will try to replicate when tuning the motion control loops of your system. After that, it comes the terminal. This is a widget that shows information of the test being performed in the configuration wizard, as we will see in other videos. After that, we can find the list of errors. This is a widget that shows a list of all the errors that have occurred since the drive has been interfaced in MotionLab3 and has been connected. So for now, we don't see any errors because we just connected the drive, for example. Then we can find the inspector. This is a widget used to configure the settings of other widgets like the scope, the display, and the control. After that, we have a notification bell, which basically tells you whether or not there are new MotionLab3 versions available. In this case, we see no notification, so there's no new software version available for download and installation. But if there were, there would be a download button here showing up that you can use to download the executable software file and install the new software. And lastly, we have an F12 button that basically is an emergency button that you can use at any time to disable the motor. You can get the same functionality by clicking the F12 button in your keyboard directly. Now, on the top left corner, you can find different drop-down features that have different purposes. First, the file, which can allow you to open a workspace, to save a workspace, and then load, save, store, and restore configurations on the drives that you have connected. Then we can find the tools. These are used to connect to the drive either through CANopen or Ethernet, and also to update the firmware of the drive. Help, you have both about and release notes about the different MotionLab 3 versions that have been released, so that you can have an overview and information of what the software provides and what each new update has solved and implemented from the previous ones. In addition to this, we have the tune and the jogs. These are two sets of workspaces. The first one used for the tuning of the different motion loops, which is both current direct, current quadrature, velocity, and position. And then we have the jogs, which is basically workspaces that are mostly tailored to be used for testing. So once you have the system properly tuned and it's more, and the responses are what you like, you can use the jogs to perform some types of movements in any of the modes of operation available in the drive, so that you can really test that the performance of the eventual system is what you expect. This is all for this video, but if you want to learn more about how to use MotionLab 3 to configure your servo drives, please do not hesitate to check our MotionLab 3 series of YouTube videos, and also do not hesitate to check out our website.